Hello, and welcome to this week's video update. It's a sunny but cold kind of a day, so I'm wrapping up a bit. Here's what I've been up to this week. First of all, I've been working on finalising some of those shows that I'm going to be attending this year. I've got three of those pretty much done. The first one is going to be the Retro Collect Fair in Leeds. I'll be there one day. I'm not sure exactly what day yet. I just need to finalise those details. But I'll be there with PowerUp, so people can have a little play at that. I'm also probably gonna come home with a few little Mega Drive treats. The second thing I'm gonna be attending is the IGC and IDGA conference in London. This was a last minute thing, really. It's basically a lot of very useful talks from a lot of very experienced independent games developers, and I want to hear what they've got to say. And that conference is happening on the 21st and 22nd of March. The third thing that I've got arranged is the update event at Media City in Manchester, which is a one-day event, and I'll be taking PowerUp along to that. That's on the 12th of April, and again, there's a few good talks there. Right, what else? Well, I've been working on getting the PC portals of PowerUp ready to go. Last week, I think I had three of them ready. Let me have a look at my details. This week, save that. Right. Yeah, this week I've made a bit of progress. I've got 6 of them ready to go. I've got one of them just waiting for final confirmation. Two of them are a bit broken and we're trying to figure out why it won't work. And three of them I'm waiting for feedback from the initial contract and the initial introductions. And one of them got back to me to say no, mainly because they only do post-Greenlight games. So that's cool. I'll be talking to them once PowerUp gets onto Steam. If PowerUp gets onto Steam, if we hit that 50% of what PowerUp needs on the Greenlight campaign, then PowerUp will be coming out on a number of PC portals on February 27th. Now, something I've done to help PowerUp to get that 50% this week, I've given out a few preview copies of PowerUp for reviewers to have a look at and a play of, and they went down pretty well, and it occurred to me that maybe I should give out a few more and try and get the word out there a bit, so I did. There are 50 copies of PowerUp, preview copies of PowerUp, circulating out there now amongst YouTubers, Twitchers, Twitchers sounds weird, and various reviewers, previewers if you like. Yeah, and basically I was doing something of a marketing push there. Hopefully we'll see that come to fruition next week, and you might have already seen one or two Twitch feeds and YouTube videos happening already. And obviously I've been working on the iOS port of PowerUp. That's coming along alright. I was hoping to get through chapter 3's enemies, general sprites and backgrounds. With all that other stuff going on, I have got through some of it. I'm about halfway through the baddie sprites for chapter 3. I'm hoping to finish those today. What I've also got through is a lot of fixes to the stuff that I sent to 2-bit. I've been fixing the credits, the character dialogue HUD's got to work a bit differently on iOS, the backgrounds. The iOS version does some smart resizing, but some of the background images don't really benefit from that, so I've had to redraw a few of those. And I've also completely redrawn all the space debris from the opening scene of the game. Now, that was done in 2D. Quite quickly after that, I realized I should probably move on to using 3D. Now the space debris took me 6 hours in total to redraw, which hopefully goes some way to explain why I've gone with rendered 3D. I'm quite glad I did, because it saved me a lot of time redrawing everything else. So that was what I was up to last week. This week I am going to be finishing off a bit of the 2D work for the iOS version. Things like the corpses for the space debris sequence, you barely see them, but if they're just enlargements of the original ones, they look a bit rubbish and it really does sort of jar. So I'm going to be redrawing that stuff. As I say, I'm going to be finishing the chapter 3 baddies today, and I'm going to be doing the chapter 3 backgrounds tomorrow. Then I'm going to be moving on to stage 4, chapter 4, whatever you want to call it. Again, baddie sprites, miscellaneous sprites for that level, and the backgrounds. While I'm doing that, I'm also going to be hopefully making more progress on the PC portals and getting those submitted, all the marketing materials they need over and out there. As I say, I've got 6 done now. I'm hoping before the release to have maybe, 10? That'd be cool. So any more than 6 next week will be a bonus. And next week we'll hopefully see the results of that marketing drive, and we'll see some reviews coming in, we'll see some Let's Plays coming in, we'll see some Twitch feeds coming in, and with a bit of luck that'll drive a lot more people to the Steam Greenlight campaign and get us off 42% and hopefully nearer to 50% by the 27th of February. So it's all a bit like that, and I'm trying all kinds of different things to move it along, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But you know, this is independent game development, this is the learning process, and I'm quite happy to earn my way to this knowledge. Right, so Hopefully there'll be a bit more news on expos and shows next week as well. There's a couple more hanging in the balance and I'll be able to tell you what's going on with those next week. And that's pretty much it. Okay, that was this week. I'll see you next week.